Hi guys, and welcome back to Top Speed Golf. I'm Clay Ballard, and I got a great drill for you today. For those of you really wanting to ramp up your speed and to get the butt into that club coming down, it's lagging, and then get that to whip on through to get the club head to really accelerate. And it's what I call the load and explode drill. And we're going to talk about how to use the lower body properly. So as I'm setting up to the golf ball, at address, I want to be nice and high. I don't want to feel like I'm way bent over. I want to feel like I'm nice and tall. If you take a look at Adam Scott or Tiger Woods or Rory McIlroy, you're going to see a lot of the same things there where they're nice and tall, good posture. And then from here, as I go to the top of my swing, I'm going to start to load my legs a little bit. So as I turn to the top, my legs are going to start to bend a little bit as they turn, my hips turn back. As I start down, then I'm going to feel like I'm loading into the ground. So my hips are going to start first. I'm going to be working down into the ground a little bit. And this is when I'm going to be having some lag with my butt into the club pointing about parallel with the ground. So if we're looking at it like this, let's imagine I was hitting that direction. As I'm coming down, my hips are going, I'm loading into the ground. My club's almost parallel with the ground here. And then from there, you can see that I have an angle between my upper leg, which would be my femur, and my torso or my pelvis there. And as I start to extend, now I'm going to drive up from my legs. And as I release the club out here in front, going to my straight line release like we talk about in the system, and then a little bit past that, now you're going to see the angle between my femur and my upper body, my torso is completely gone as I come up into the finish and I've extended these angles. So I'm loading into the ground, and then to get that club to turn back up, you know, the butt end of the club's going to go from pointing down to pointing back up. It's only going to move about a foot while the club head moves 8 or 10 feet. That's what's going to get that club to whip on through there. That's when I'm going to be exploding up to help turn that grip back in up toward my body. That's going to really get it to accelerate. So as I finish, I want to have this angled almost back just a little bit like that as I come all the way on around. So here's what I want you to do for the drill. Number one, we're going to start nice and high. We have to start tall so we can feel like we load down in the ground and get some pressure. So we're going to start nice and tall. As I go to the top of the backswing, I'm going to start to feel like I come down a little bit. As I continue down, I'm going to pause when my hands are just about at my right leg. And here, my club is going to be pretty much parallel with the ground. Now from there, as I make a practice swing, I'm going to pause here. And then as I make a practice swing, I'm going to stand. I'm going to drive my legs up. I'm going to get the butt into this club to drive up. And I'm going to go to my straight line release point, which would be here. And I'm going to feel like I'm extended as I come through my leg. So I'm going to do about 100 repetitions. Pausing, loading, and then really driving into the ground, getting the butt into the club to turn up and the club to whip on through. 100 repetitions pausing, then I'm gonna do 100 reps going nice, easy, smooth practice swings. There we go. Full speed, or let's say 80% speed, really getting that club to whip through there, and then we're gonna go ahead and hit some shots doing this. So I'm gonna change the camera angle so we can see these. I'll give you a slow motion video, and then notice how my legs load into the ground, and then I explode up out of the ground to get the club to turn back up and that club to whip on through. So good luck to you guys. Good luck in these drills. I'll see y'all soon. I guys, hope y'all really enjoyed this video. If you did, I got a fantastic bonus for you. And we know if we really want to rip that golf ball, we want to get lots of distance, we got to have tons of lag, and then we got to release that lag to get a lot of speed. And I got a video that goes over the number one lag mistake that I see being made time and time again. I'm going to play a preview of that video. If you want to see the entire thing, get instant access to it, just click the link that pops up on your screen. If you're on a mobile device, go ahead and open up the description down below and click on the link in the description. You'll get instant access to it there. Plus, you're going to get 5 bonus videos from our Top Speed Golf system. They're going to walk you through the entire system. If you guys have any questions, post them in the comments below. Click that thumbs up button. It really helps us out. I appreciate you guys tuning in. I'll see you all soon. Remember to subscribe so you'll see our latest videos, and I'll see you in the lag video. Hi guys, and welcome back. I'm Clay Ballard, and in today's video, we're going to talk about one of the absolute worst drills for creating lag. It's a very common drill that I see, and in this drill, what we're gonna do is we're gonna set the wrist very early to create an angle of lag, and then we're gonna try to hold this throughout the swing. It's one of the worst things that you can do to build lag. I'm gonna talk about the science behind why this is the case, and I'm also gonna give you a great drill to help you improve your lag all in this video. Let's go ahead and get started. I do it this way versus holding that position. Exact same thing happens when we're building lag in the golf swing. So what we wanna do is throughout the swing, I wanna have a very low and wide takeaway. So I'm not gonna set my wrist early at all. If you look at a lot of the top players, you look at Adam Scott, very wide takeaway, not very much wrist set at all. You look at Rory McIlroy, look at Tiger Woods, all these players are using a wide takeaway and not getting very much wrist set, so that later in the swing, as we start down, we can increase this wrist set, and we're really only gonna max out this angle of lag for a split second in the downswing. Okay, so a three-step drill here. Now, as we get started with this, I want to remind you that the fulcrum in this golf club for getting a massive amount of lag is right at the end of the golf club. This is where I want my hinge point to be. I want to use the full length of this club to build lag and then release lag.